So hello guys and welcome back to a new video on the channel, and today I was invited down to the Bristol City Press Conference ahead of tomorrow's game against Swansea City. So I got to ask a couple of questions to right back Zac Vyner and also the manager Dean Holden. So in this video you will see the whole press conferences from both Dean Holden's and Zac Vyner's views on tomorrow's game. So if you do go on to enjoy, make sure to like and subscribe, turn on notifications so you never miss a new video from me. I'll also put the times of when I ask both of them the questions in the description if you only want to go and see that. But yeah, hope you do go on and enjoy the video. And yeah, here's the press conference.
Hiya, Zac. Can you hear me okay?
Hey, all good. How are you?
Yeah, not too bad. Not too bad. So, what's the feeling among the players after the loss, first loss of the season, unfortunately, on Tuesday night?
Obviously, we know that we weren't at the races, and we want to be able to put that right and kind of move on from it quickly. And at the moment, with the amount of games that we do have coming thick and fast, we can go and put that right straight away. So it's definitely something that we want to rectify as quick as we can and put to bed as quick as we can. And go again on Saturday.
Your fellow defender Alfie Mawson had to come off during the game. Have you seen him at all? How's he doing?
No, I don't have too much information on that. I don't really know. I've seen him, but I haven't got too much information on that.
And how do you sum up your own form at the moment, Zac? How are things going? You put in some great challenges in the last few games I've saw, in particular up at Barnsley. I remember you nipping in and stopping Corley Woodrow in the first few seconds of that game and looked like some really good defending. How do you assess it yourself?
No, I'm feeling confident at the moment. I'm feeling good. I've played in all the games and I'm feeling like I just want to keep the momentum building. Like you say, I feel like I've done well as a start, and it is a start and it's early on in the season. I want to keep moving and keep building on what I'm doing, and I'm not looking too far ahead. I just want to keep going on to the next one. So I know that's a cliche, but it is true in this case. So I want to just keep building on what I've done in the next game before that.
Congratulations on your recent new contract. Very well deserved, I think. And also as an academy player coming through the ranks at Bristol City, it must be especially rewarding for yourself. Also that Max, a friend of yours who's come through the ranks as well, has signed one. How do you see that? You must be pleased that that's all sorted.
Thank you. Yeah, I appreciate it. It's definitely something that I'm happy about, and like you say, like to do it with a mate that I've done it with I've been at City for years, so it's been great, and to be able to do it together is great, and to have that kind of familiar face from the academy, so to speak, with you is also a really good thing to have in the first team squad. And like you say, we've come through the academy together. So when I think it was our first game that we'd ever played in a senior appearance against Northampton earlier on in the season. So that was obviously a big moment for all of our families and everything like that. So it's been really good. The last few months it's been a good few months.
Just remind us again of your background before you came to the club, Zac. Am I right thinking that you are a Bathonian coming from Bath just down the road? And I've lived in Bath a fair while myself previously. Did you ever play for any of the teams like Bath Arsenal or anybody like that, or play against those guys?
Yeah, so I was born in Peckham. I moved to Bath when I was 9 and I joined Bath Arsenal. So I played for Bath Arsenal for a few months and then ended up getting picked up by Bristol City and kind of come through there, obviously. But yeah, and I really enjoyed that kind of young experience, just playing in tournaments and going around, and I was a striker at the time, so I was I just used to shoot from everywhere, really. But it was definitely a lot of fun, I've got nothing but good things to say about that kind of young experience of playing football in the Sunday League kind of vibe.
Sure. And how long were you at Bristol City for? How long have you been in the academy for? What age was that you joined roughly?
I joined when I was 9, so I joined straight away. So I only played for a few months really at Bath Arsenal, and then signed for City, went to a trial at Bristol, and it was definitely an eye opener, that trial, because there was about 100 kids there turned up, and we all kind of just went off to different corners of the pitch and just did our own little thing. And then obviously a couple of weeks later, got like a big booklet, got given to I think it was my grandparents at the time, actually. I think my parents were away, and it was my grandparents who got given it. And I remember calling my parents and saying, oh yeah, like I got in and all this sort of stuff. So it was definitely a good moment for me back then, and I can remember it like it was yesterday now. So it's great to kind of progress through, and now playing in the first team here is amazing for me.
Just one last question on that and your background. I think I'm right saying this. Somebody has said to me that your dad is loosely connected to football as well, and that he'd done some painting or something out at one of the World Cups even, or is it like an illustrator? Is that right? And I think he might even have gone out to Russia, the last World Cup.
Yeah, so he's an artist, and he's a professor at Bath Uni. And he got permission to go out to Russia from the Telegraph and do some paintings and some drawing for them. And he loves it. You know, he gets to go to all these great sporting events. He's done Olympics over the course of like years ago and stuff. And he's done other World Cups. So he's been out to a lot of sporting events that I'm very jealous about. I know he's working, but he's also getting to see a lot of good football. And he enjoys it.
So has he painted a picture of you yet?
He hasn't, not yet. That's next on the list.
Fair enough. And just finally, obviously, Swansea City up next, and obviously Casey Palmer can't play in this one, but Corey Smith most likely will do. It's going to be a bit odd, isn't it, coming up against him?
Yeah, definitely. He's going to, obviously, someone that I've looked up to for a lot of years. I've made my debut alongside him as well, so I'm definitely going to be a bit weird to play against him, but it'll be good. You know, we know what he brings and he knows what we bring. So it'll be a good test to see how we nullify it and go from there. But it'll be a good game. You know, it'll be a tough game, but we're also ready for it. And we want to go and get 3 points. And like I said, rectify what happened the other night and go again.
Nice one. Cheers, Zach. Good luck.
Cheers.
So good afternoon, Zach. So how's the feeling in the camp been recently, obviously after Saturday's late equaliser and Tuesday's first loss of the season? So how are you and the squad feeling ahead of tomorrow's game?
We're a positive group, you know. We obviously wanna put things right from the last two tough results, but we wanna be able to bounce back quickly, you know, and I think early on in the season these things are gonna happen. We've had a good start to the season, but like I said earlier on, it is a start. We want to be able to build on the results that we had earlier on in the season and keep the momentum rolling from that. And like you say, we're a group that we've taken, I think the gaffer used the punch on the nose. We've taken that and we want to keep moving now. We want to just keep it rolling onto the next game. And we have got a positive group that will get around each other. And we want to go and get 3 points on Saturday.
Yeah. And finally, how have you and the squad been preparing for obviously Swansea tomorrow? And then also we've got a very tricky schedule over the next couple of months. So how have you and the squad been preparing for that?
Yeah, I mean it's been good. We've got in today and we've had a meeting on them and on us and what we want to do, and we're big believers in focusing on ourselves to be able to get the result. And we obviously know that they pose some good threats, but we also want to be able to implement our game, and when we're on it, we'll feel like we can get the result. You've probably got a few tough games coming up, but I mean that's just the nature of it. You know, we want to be able to play against everybody and challenge with everybody. And you know, we've got a tight schedule coming up, but we're all ready for it. And you know, it's our bread and butter. You know, we want to be playing games. We want to be able to go again every time and keep putting a performance in like we have done earlier on in the season.
Brilliant. Thanks, Zach. Good luck tomorrow.
So, a couple of days on after the Middlesbrough game. How do you reflect on that match now? Tough night at the office.
Yeah, it's probably the first time this season we've not been at our best. We didn't open Middlesbrough enough, open them up enough to create the chances that we needed to win the game. It's the first time that's happened this season. We've created lots of chances in all the games. So, they made it difficult, of course. It just wasn't to be on the night. We have to move on quickly. We reviewed the game as we always do. We reflect on it. And as I say, it's a big game around the corner now, a totally different game tomorrow. So we have to be better tomorrow. We have to get our standards back up to the levels that they were previously.
How did you see the midfield battle on Tuesday night? Often a very key area in matches, and obviously Middlesbrough, credit to them, they were pretty dogged and physical in there. How do you assess your three in the middle?
As I say, you know, you're going up against three really good championship midfielders, in my opinion, for Middlesbrough. And, you know, they go man-to-man in there and they make it difficult and try not to give you any space. Of course, our players, Tyreek's getting a little bit of attention now from his previous performances. Obviously, everybody already knows about Andy and Pato, what they can bring. So they were never going to make it easy for us. I don't think they probably got enough quality ball in the right areas, if we're being honest, for whatever reason. So, as I say, it was one of them games that we have to move on quickly from.
Alfie Mawson was obviously stretchered off. How's he doing?
Yeah, he's in decent spirits at the moment. He's had a scan and we're just waiting now. I think it's on Monday where we'll see a specialist and we'll see the sort of, you know, the way that we're going to move forward with it.
What is the injury? Do we know? Is it part of his ankle? Is it knee or?
Yeah, he's got a knee injury.
Okay, and there's no initial idea on how long he might be out for.
No, I wouldn't put any timescale until we've seen a specialist. That's the reason he's a specialist. He's an expert, of course. So, you know, we need to wait on his guidance.
Okay, and how's the rest of the squad doing, Dean, for Saturday?
Yeah, we're looking all right, Gregory. It's just, as I say, it's always difficult when you turn the games around so quickly because there's always a little bit of fatigue and some niggles and stuff that you get in any game. So, you know, as we move closer towards the game, we'll know exactly, you know, who we've got available.
Any chance Liam Walsh or Joe Williams could be back for this one?
Not for this one, no, Gregory, no.
Okay, and obviously Swansea City up next. How do you assess the challenge of them? And obviously they've got a familiar face in midfield there.
Yeah, it'd be great to see Corey, of course. He's an incredible servant for this football club. And but it's not just about Corey, you know, they're a good team. I like the way they go about things, the way that they play. I've got a lot of respect for the management team there. And they've got some threats all over the pitch, in fairness. They're a team that they want to take the ball. They want to play open, expansive football. They get the wing-backs really high up the pitch. They try and cause you problems. So, yeah, we've studied them as much as we can. And we're ready for them. And we'd like to think, as I say, we get back to our level that we've got players that can hurt them as well.
Do you see any added extra emphasis on this fixture? Because one, they're a little bit local, and two, maybe they're a top six rival.
We're under no illusions. It's a big game for the football club. I think it's one the supporters always look towards as well. So, you know, the players are fully aware of that. At the same time, it's the next 3 points on offer, and you know, they've started the season well, as have we. And you know, our boys focusing on us. We've had a promising start. The players have got some good performances already, and obviously some good results. So. Every game you go into is going to be difficult for different reasons, and this is going to be a real tough game, I'd say. You know, I think they're one of the better teams in the division. They missed out narrowly, of course, last season. They've added some quality as well, so you know, we'll cause any team problems. We've got to make sure, as I say, that we get to our level that we've shown previously.
And just finally on yourself, Dean, how are you finding management at the moment? Obviously, you've had your first loss now, and first league loss as a permanent head coach at Bristol City. Yeah, how's it going?
Oh, it's fantastic. That's a challenge. Of course, you want to win every football game. I don't know any manager that's won every single game in his management career. So, of course, these are the challenges that you face. And the biggest challenge for me is making sure that we stay together as a group. We win and lose together as a football club. We had an off night the other night. That's all it was. We've had a real good start, as I say. We stay nice and calm and we focus on ourselves and get back to our levels. And that's the challenge of management. That's a challenge that I love every day. And these quick turnarounds are great because you've got to use everything in your locker to make sure the players are ready physically and mentally for that next one.
Nice one. Good luck for Saturday.
Cheers, Gregor.
Well, so good afternoon, Dean. Hope you are keeping well. So, firstly, coming off the back of the first loss on Tuesday, how have you worked with your assistants and the players to try and get back to winning ways tomorrow?
Hi, Ben. Well, it's difficult when you've got such a quick turnaround in games, but the process remains the same. We quickly reflect on the previous performance, what we did well, what we didn't do so well. We review that with the players, and then we have to move quickly on to that next one. So I've spent a lot of time focusing on the challenge that Swansea are going to bring. And, you know, they're a good team. Of course, they went close last season and they've added some quality as well. So they're going to be a big challenge. But you know, for us, the focus is on getting to the level that we'd shown previously prior to the Middlesbrough game. The players have been performing well. We've been creating chances, big chances in all the games. And as I say, that's been the main focus.
Yeah, so we also have a very tricky run of games coming up in quite a short amount of time. So how are you working with the squad? And how are you guys feeling about our squad depth and the busy schedule coming up?
Excited about the busy schedule, as you say. This is what the Championship is. Big game after big game every 3 or 4 days. We've certainly got that coming up in the next couple of weeks. It's a huge challenge for the squad, but that's why you have a squad, Ben. So, you know, players will come to the fore now that maybe previously weren't getting as much game time. And as I say, you know, you pick up niggles along the way. You have to assess where every player's at and think which part of the team needs freshening up at the right time. And as I say, that's the challenge as a manager, the challenge you enjoy. And as I say, all the focus is on this next game. We're not thinking about the games after Swansea, although the big games on the horizon, we're only focusing on Swansea.
Yeah, and so finally, we didn't manage to get a shot on target on Tuesday night. So have you been working with the strikers, the midfielders, to try and bring back the 3 points again tomorrow?
Yeah, it's a great question, Ben. Of course, every day, whether we're, as I say, there's been a quick turnaround, so we've not had much time to get out on the grass and actually physically work on that. That's why pre-season is so important. That's why your 3 weeks, you know, your national breaks are important to get all this work in, so it's there when you need it. Whether we're training on the grass, whether we're reviewing with the video, whether it's just conversations one-to-one with certain players, as I say, we're calm. We're in a good place at the moment. And, you know, we focus, as I say, on the process. We focus on, you know, what we're good at and how we can hurt Swansea.
Thanks, Dean. Good luck tomorrow.
Thanks, Ben. See you, mate.